Hello everyone, welcome to Book Tales by Pritha. Today I will recommend you 5 short story books in this particular video. I am planning to make more videos on this particular topic, so it will come as a series one by one. Because right now I am reading couple of short story books, which once I finish I will again put a new video on that particular topic. Also, I would like to know, have you subscribed my channel Book Tales by Pritha? If you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe it, because if you subscribe my channel, then you get to know whenever I post a new video. I post a new video every week, so if you want to see each of the videos, then you must subscribe Book Tales by Pritha. Book Tales by Pritha is also there in Facebook. On Facebook, there is a Facebook page and a Facebook group by the name Book Tales by Pritha. Book Tales by Pritha is also there on Instagram. There is a personal account of mine by the name Pritha Sharkar 18 on Twitter. And you can follow me over there, because over there also I talk about books and my choices regarding my reading preference, etc. All the link of all the books that I would be mentioning in this particular video of mine will also be placed in the description section below. So once you finish watching this video, do check out the description section, because the affiliate link of all the books as well as the social media handle of Book Tales by Pritha is mentioned there. Also, before I forget, there is a blog of mine where I specifically write about my experiences with books. The particular name is prithasnotebook.wordpress.com. You can follow me also on my blog. So without further ado, let's start today's video. The first book that I would like to recommend in this particular video is a book called No Present Please by Jen Kaikini. I don't have a physical copy of this particular book, but I hope to get it soon. This book, I think, was originally written in Kannada. This is one of the best book which talks about Bombay, today called Mumbai. The short stories in this particular book depicts the emotion that is so closely associated with Bombay. It reflects Mumbaiya culture, the Mumbaiya lifestyle, the Bombay movie halls before the so-called multiplexes came into India or the Maya Nagari. I could so well connect to some of the stories, because I have seen some of the things in front of my eyes, because I have lived some of my initial days of my early 20s in that particular city, which is called Maya Nagari. So if you want to get a hold of a good book which talks about Bombay with very intimate intrinsic details, then there is, I think, this book can serve your purpose. And also I suggest that if you want to give this book as a present to some of your closed ones, they would be very happy. The book's name is also very amazing one. It is No Presents Please. Try out this book, read it, and let me know in the comment section how you like this particular book. I would be waiting for your response in my comment section. The second book that I would like to recommend for today's video is this book, A Quiver Full of Arrows by Jeffrey Archer. If you see the cover, it is an old cover. Actually, this is a second-hand book which I got for only 40 rupees. Now, let me tell you why you should read this amazing book with amazing short stories. This is my first book that I have read by Jeffrey Archer, and I regret for not reading him for so long. Each of the stories in this particular book is specific to one or two particular country. It talks about the lifestyle of people residing in those countries. Each of the stories has got some amazing characterization. There is satire element in the end of some of the stories. And I tell you, please read the end, last 2-3 paragraphs of each of the story, because you know what, in the end he gives you something that was very unexpected, and that makes the story very special. Also, I would like to tell you how simple English, mind-blowing stories can attract a reader's attention. That is what Jeffrey Archer has presented us to this amazing book called Quiver Full of Arrows. Please read this book if you want, and do let me know in the comment section how you like this amazing book called Quiver Full of Arrows by Jeffrey Archer. The next book that I would like to recommend to you is this one. This is Interpreter of Maladies by Jhumpa Lahiri. You must be knowing that this book is the winner of Pulitzer Prize for Fiction in the year 2000. This is one of the highly recommended short story books worldwide. Now, what makes this book so special? Let me tell you, I became a fan of Jhumpa Lahiri long back when I read Namesake. Her language is her most important potential that I think. Next, the subject that she chooses. Predominantly her subject is about the NRI Bengalis who are residing in American cities and countries. This book is no different. The stories are mostly about people who are NRIs, who are mostly Bengalis and who are residing in USA. The best story that I liked in this particular book was by the name Interpreter of Maladies. In that case, there was a couple with their children who came to visit India, and what happens as the story takes place forward. So, if you are reading a book by Jhumpa Lahiri, in most of the cases, you will find the subject being NRI Bengalis with mind-blowing story subject matter and amazing English language. If you want to learn how to write, how to read good English language, then please read books by Jhumpa Lahiri. And if you want to begin, then definitely Interpreter of Maladies is one of the best recommendation that I or anyone can give you in a book recommendation video. I definitely have to recommend one book by Murakami in a short story recommendation video, and in this particular video I recommend to you a book called Desire. This is one of the first book that I read by Haruki Murakami. Haruki Murakami's English is difficult. It is not a suggestion for entry level readers but for advanced level readers, but still I recommend Desire in this particular video, because I think if you want to begin Murakami, then read his short story collection, and you can definitely begin with this particular book, which is a vintage edition. This book is called Desire. You know what, in Murakami's world, it is mostly the surreal world. So many entry level readers might find understanding the stories of Murakami a bit difficult. It really takes time to understand the stories. You may have to read the same story not once but twice to understand its inner meaning, to understand its worth. But trust me, if you start liking Murakami, then I tell you, it is something else. It is like, somebody had told me long back when I was beginning to read books by Murakami, that you know, the books by Murakami is like inhaling opium. It takes attention into a reader's mind slowly, gradually. But once you start understanding Murakami and his surreal world, you feel good. You feel something else altogether. So again, I say that if you want to begin reading Murakami, then I would definitely tell you that Desire is one of the best books. You will also see in my Instagram handle by the name Book Tales by Pritha. This is one of the first books that I had posted, because it was at that point of time when I started reading Murakami. Understanding came much later, but once I got a hold of it, it is a different level altogether. Being a Bengali, how can in a short story book recommendation I can forget to tell about short stories by Rabindranath Tagore? He is the greatest writer of all times. That is what I personally believe. Since I had Hindi as my second language, so most of the stories of Tagore which I have read, I'm sorry to say this, I have read it in English. I have time and again heard my parents telling that it is in Bengali that the essence of his stories are better understood. But what can I do? I had this language barrier. But you know what? If you start reading Tagore, you will understand that Tagore has written for every season, for every occasion, for every emotion, for every kind of individual. And to begin Tagore, I would always suggest, anybody will always suggest you, begin with the short stories by Tagore. I have the entire Tagore collection, but it is there in Bengali. So that is the reason I will put the link of some of the English short story book collection in the description section below, as well as the other books that I have recommended to you all in this particular video. So let me know in the comment section how you like the book recommendation that I made to you all in this particular video. Also let me know some other good authors and writers that you have read, whom you find relevant and good writers for short story recommendation, because even your opinions matter to me, so that I can also read them, enlighten myself, my limited knowledge that I have, which I try to share with you all in my videos. And if you like today's video, please like the video, please subscribe my channel, please tell about my channel to your friends and relatives and your near and dear ones, because if you do so, trust me, then it helps very small YouTubers like us to grow in this big community. And to let you all know whatever little bit knowledge that I have gained in all these years. Hope to see you soon in my next video, which would be posted next week. Till then, tata and bye bye.